Well, hello everyone. We have made it to the 11-11 portal, where heaven meets earth, and you're standing in the sweet spot. We're going to tune into some different oracle decks and a couple different tarot decks to just see where spirit wants to lead us. Where are we going? What's being activated? What's coming up? What do we need to be prepared for? What's happening in this portal energy? Let's find out. I am curious. I am excited because I feel like the energy has been a little chaotic for the collective, even for myself, for friends of mine. I am sending everybody so much love and so much light. It's time for balance. It's time for the new world. Time to expand, to grow into new versions of ourselves. So what's being activated in this portal right now, the 11-11 portal, whenever you're listening to this, is the perfect time because this energy is going to take us from 2022 all the way to the 11-11 portal in 2023. Let go. Come on, spirit. Wow. Out of all the cards that could have came out of that deck, of the cosmic greeting cards, let go. So let go of how you think it should be. Let go of those connections that are not serving you, that are toxic. Let go of belief systems, programs, codependencies. Let go of worry, concern, stress, fears. Let go. 19 is a 10. That's a cycle end for new beginnings. And look at how beautiful the new beginnings are. It's like this is the portal. This is the 11-11 portal opening up for brilliant, amazing, abundant, prosperous new beginnings in all aspects of your life. As long as you can let go of what's already done, of what's dead and no longer thriving, whatever that is to you. As soon as you let go of this portal is completely visible and clear, and you can jump right in. That's what I'm feeling. So that's a big theme, let go. So we're going to dive into the silhouette tarot and ask, like, exactly what are we letting go of? And at the bottom, this is interesting, okay, walk your truth. So these messages are for all of the light, star seeds, healers, mystics, light workers. Walk your truth. Like, you have healing hands. Just a gentle embrace, a hand on the shoulder helps people heal. You have that ability. And look at it. It looks like you're coming out of the portal, right? You're jumping into the portal, like letting go, right? You're jumping in, and this is you coming in through the other side of this portal. And things are being activated, especially in your hands. Something about using your hands. If you use your hands to create things, to make things, they're going to be beautiful and they're going to help people heal. Whatever that is, it doesn't matter what it is. Lots of things can help people heal, right? This is, if you been thinking about a healer's path of some kind, this is your confirmation that that is what is being activated. It's like you have everything in the palm of your hands. Spirit wants you to know that. You have everything in the palm of your hands. And walk your truth. Be authentic. Okay, we're going to read about that. Spirit wants us to read about that a little bit. But first we're going to read the little quote for let go. It's time to relinquish your need for control and let the leaves fall as they may. Wow, how interesting is that? If you have not listened to, you know, the full moon lunar eclipse reading that I posted recently, please do, because it talks all about control. And we're in the fall season here where I'm at, so let the leaves fall as they may. Yes, let go. So it's just time. It's just time. And then you walk your truth, right? You jump through the portal and you walk your truth. You be authentic. You know, fly that weird flag high. You're not meant to be like everybody else. See your light and know your power. Have the courage to walk your truth. True empowerment comes from walking, living, and speaking your truth. Having the courage to be guided by your heart and follow your dreams. The affirmation for this card is, I am guided by the universal spirit of love as I follow my heart in all that I do. Following your heart always. It goes along with the messages, though, of walking your truth and living in your destiny. The things that were activated in the eclipse, or the things that were, you know, you can see clearly that you need to let go of, because that's what eclipses do. Eclipse out things that aren't serving us, like a storm, like a tower. And it's about your true north, your North Star. So it was in conjunct with the North Star, which is your destiny. So it's something about really stepping into your destiny. And it's something about your creativity, a healer's path, your spirituality. Tell us more, Spirit. Tell us more. Spirit is guiding this entire reading. There is no set topics, but just wanted to come through for all of you lightworkers, starseeds, mystics, healers, all of the light. Page of Cups. So, something new. And to me, there's two things that I see in this picture for this reading for all of you. This looks like a snail shell, so like slow moving, right? Things have seemed like they're moving slow. And it looks like that the page is holding a hose, right? So first you hose off everything, right? You release the past, you let go, you cleanse yourself, you detox mind, body, heart, and spirit, right? Then you go, you connect with nature, with Mother Earth. And then what I also feel from this card is you're kind of pulling in, after you let go, you're pulling in the wisdom from plant medicine, from Mother Earth. You're pulling in the stability that you've been asking for. You're pulling in the abundance that you've been asking for, the new vitality, the new spark. And this Page of Cups makes me feel like this is new. You're really feeling more balanced in your heart space when you let go and you open up to this, to the truth. You allow yourself to see the truth. And there's a lot of wisdom to be gained in some kind of new start that seemed like it was taking a really long time. That's what I'm feeling. But let's get a little bit more on this Page of Cups. And I also feel that you're leaving immature, childlike behaviors within yourself behind. And you're also leaving immature, toxic, childish people behind. Ooh. Wow. Okay. That's a lot of stuff that just tried to come out. But it's like the ones that flipped up and were stubborn. Like the Queen of Swords is like, yes, I am supposed to be here. This is your clarity, please. Okay. Yeah. So exactly what I felt. That's why the Queen came out. Get clear. Find the balance of the head and the heart. Leave behind whatever it is. Cut it away. Because the Queen would cut it away. The Queen of Swords, very logical, very discerning. Yeah, I feel into my heart and I know it's time to let go. So I am going to, because I have the butterfly in my hand and I'm ready for new life. Seeing things from spirit's perspective, following your heart, right? Towards your destiny. So it's like getting really clear. The Queen's like, come on. And it's leaving this behind, this feeling of resentment, regret, like you were left in the dark, something didn't work out. But guess what? All those things that didn't work out, all those shut doors helped you learn about yourself. That's the wisdom that you're, you know, getting from the tree. So your first release, right, with the hose, hosing things off, and then look at how much growth that you don't realize that you've had because of these experiences that were uncomfortable. This is what you're leaving behind, the closed doors, because when you do that, this portal is open to walk your truth, people that didn't understand you, people that didn't accept you, people that just left you out for cold, or at least it felt that way. But all change is good change. So this is about changing things and walking away from the regrets, right? And then when you do that, when you change things, when you take the wisdom and you get clear with this queen energy is really important to get clear, to stay focused on what you want, not what you don't want. Move forward. Spirit's helping clear the way here and finding your balance. And then this new path opens, the Ace of Wands. This is a gift that the universe is giving you in this 1111 portal energy, heaven on earth. I'm giving you a new start, new spark. That's the spark that I kept feeling, right? This is the new spark, the Ace of Wands. The new path, a new way, something new. Newfound vitality, right? Burning that spiritual fire, getting your butt moving forward. So that's brand new beginnings in the 1111 portal. I love it. Walking your truth as the Queen of Swords would. The Queen of Swords is a very truthful energy. So first you have to get truthful with yourself, and then this new path opens. You take the wisdom that you've gained, the growth, and you walk away from things that aren't working. What's coming on this path? Oh, yes. Magic, manifestation, new beginnings. And that what I love about this and the way that the artist came through in the silhouette, I love these. But it's like, see how the chameleon or the lizard, I guess chameleon, right, blending in? Like, it's kind of like you've been kind of just blending in, maybe in the shadows, like in the background, right? Just kind of, you know, learning, observing, not really wanting to stand out. But now it's time to walk your truth and stand out. Like, show your craft. And look, you can see it now. It's being revealed now. You're revealing yourself. Someone's revealing themselves. And it's like magic. It's beautiful. Putting on a show. Getting ready for a show. Something new. Stepping out into the spotlight. Shining your light. Walking your truth. And the truth is, you are the magician. The truth is, you're a master manifester. So you're showing this. Your art. Your craft. Something creative with your hands. I mean, it's beautiful. It's like magic. See, this portal is bringing in magic and new beginnings. You get a 1-1. I mean, wow. Use this energy. It's like breaking through the portal, right? That's been tough. It's been challenging. Yeah, definitely. But you're making it through to the other side. And your light, your love, your magic healing abilities are very important. Your creative talents, music, art, writing a book, poetry, whatever this is. Literal magic. You're getting on stage and magic. You're, you know, a performer of some kind. Whatever this is, express yourself. Go for it. You're moving into stability. So Spirit's asking you, what are you holding on so tight to? Because as soon as you let go, the stability comes in. There's a bank that's going to give you a loan. There's money coming in, and angels are helping you with your stability. But if we're holding on too tight to the past, or we're holding on to an idea of how something should go, definitely listen to my last video I posted on the eclipse. I really feel it's important if you haven't listened to it. Maybe listen to it again. You might hear something different. But this is the key. The key to your stability, to manifesting this new path, this new beginning, the new spark, getting, you know, balance and clarity, is to release, let go, surrender. Anything else? Anything else you want to say about this particular message? Okay. Hibernation. So you have plenty. When this card comes out, it's like you've collected what you need, right? You have plenty. There's no need to worry. And, you know, it may be time to, like, take a little rest, go within, get some healing, hibernate. Coming into a time where you're going to be able to rest. You're almost there. Don't give up, because you're almost there. And this is about being independent, free thinking, unique, nighttime magic, psychic gifts, intuition. Trust your intuition here. what I feel from these two cards working together is you'll know when it's time to take action. You may have been in a time of hibernation, like you're in the dark, right, in the cave. And I feel what Spirit is saying is it's almost time to come out of hibernation and to release. You have plenty. You can come out from hiding. You can come out into the spotlight. You're ready. Because look, Queen of Wands. You're ready. You're ready to take center stage. And there's the cat spirit again. Independent, free thinking, creative, beautiful, gorgeous, attracting things to you. That's what the queen energy brings in. This is taking that Ace of Wands and moving forward, dropping the burdens, letting go, and then you come into this leadership position. This beautiful sweet spot of heaven on earth, right? With clarity. Leadership. I feel a lot of leadership energy coming in. And it can be these queens that come in and help you get clarity. Someone gives you a great idea. You talk to a counselor. You speak to someone about what you want to do moving forward. And they're right there for you to give you good advice. You know, this can be a boss, like, finally recognizing your work and, like, you're almost there and you're getting that raise, right? I mean, definitely can take it how it resonates. You may be cutting out one relationship and opening up to something different. Yeah, the Hierophant, commitment. Yeah, wow, and I just said relationship. So there's some kind of a higher level of commitment coming in with your current partner, I'm feeling, or you're committing to someone. This is committing to a spiritual path with the Ace of Wands. Like making commitments. You're moving into a time with this portal where you can come out of hibernation and show yourself. Launch that creative project. And you're committing to this new path. You're committing to a path of integrity. I mean, it's a beautiful path. There's commitment, and it is about your spirituality with all the wand energy. And this reminds me of the hermit energy with the hibernation. It's like using all your resources that you've been gathering, all the wisdom that you've been gathering, and you're moving forward on this new path. And you're becoming like a mentor. You're becoming a teacher. Yeah, something new. Page of Coins. There's something new happening in the material world. An offer, an opportunity, learning something new, learning from this mentor type person, learning about manifestation and magic. But it's some kind of opportunity, going back to school. This can also be for someone, you're making a commitment, higher level of commitment, and you're going to have a child. Because that's child energy, and I just felt that for somebody, that special message. Yeah, you're coming into, because the 1111 portal is the twin flame soulmate divine partner portal as well. And I will be posting something about that. But this is the king and queen. See, you've had to walk the path that you've walked to get ready, right? It's time to walk in your spiritual truth. It's time to level up. Boss it up. Commitment. There's something new. There's a new job opportunity, a new creative project. And I feel that the masculine and feminine are going to work together. And this is sacred union, like coming together. Let's do something new together. I do feel that, the king and queen. Communication coming in, information coming in. A lot of back and forth can be traveling coming through this portal. You're going to be traveling more this next year, communicating back and forth in a very passionate way. You could be apart from one another. Someone could start a job where they're traveling, right? And you're going to be doing a lot of communication, a lot of back and forth, but that's good. It feels good to me. It's very passionate. It's very honest. It's a new start. Page of Wands. It's taking that Ace of Wands, the new path. There is something new because you got the Page of Cups, the Page of Wands, the Page of Coins, of Pentacles, right? So you've got all this new energy. So it's definitely something new. If it's with a relationship you're already in, then it's something new. You're communicating in a different way. There's somebody's job is shifting. Creative project is really taking off and your life is changing. And you're going to be able to travel more. It's something. Something is changing. Higher level of commitment here with the Hierophant, for sure. And if this is a job opportunity, a partnership in that way, it's really going to take off. And it's going to take off fast. Anything else? Anything else we need to know? This feels really important. And it has everything to do with your spiritual connection and your North Node, your destiny. We're going to look at this here. And I'm going to grab the book because this is one of the special ones. And at the bottom is the death card. So this is the rebirth time. You see all the butterflies? And that's the letting go and walking your truth. And I feel with that person with the hat, it is like the magician. So it's like walk your truth. Walk your spiritual truth. Shine your light. Express your magic. And we're just going to see what this one has to say from the artist's perspective. And the hibernation card I wanted to point out, because that is a special card. The roughness is about to pass. The accumulating strength is, and you're just waiting for the opportunity. And I feel like the opportunity is coming. Like, that's what that is saying. And for some reason, I'm having a hard time finding this beautiful one. Oh, this is the heart space. Okay. Inner calm and peace, having independent thinking mind. Yes, like the Queen of Swords and Queen of Wands would. It's independent thinking. You're unique. You're talented. You're gifted. You're different because you're supposed to be. They put on their top hat. Back to the inner world. Represents the quiet blue. It seemed to reveal their tranquil heart. So somebody's feelings, like the Page of Cups, are going to be revealed. Somebody's feelings are going to be revealed. Your feelings are going to be revealed to you even. Maybe you don't even know how you feel about this person, this opportunity, till it comes your way. And it's time to really go within, okay? And unleash your magic. We're going to clean this up and we're going to move on to the next set of messages. Okay, the next set of messages, we are going to use the Starseed Oracle and see what comes out. What's our main theme, Spirit, moving forward in this 1111 portal for all Starseeds, mystics, healers, light workers, all of the light, anyone and everyone that was guided here to my channel at any time. What is the main message here, Spirit? Earth pulsing. Pulse of the mother. Slow down. Take some time in nature. So, Spirit wants you to slow down. Enjoy that sweet spot. Heaven on earth. I mean, look at this card. It's gorgeous. Heaven on earth. That's what the 1111 portal is bringing. So we're going to look up earth pulsing and just see what it says. A mysterious pulse is woven through all of life. The planet itself has a rhythm. You can see it in the seasons and the tides. In our world of artificial lighting, long working hours, and modern conveniences, it's easy for us to feel stuck and off kilter. It's time to reconnect with nature and surrender to the pulse of the earth. Earth pulsing is a wonderful tool for surrendering to the rhythmic pulse of the mother and the entire universe. Today, many of us are disconnected from the land beneath us. Somewhere along the way, a severing happened, a moment when it became too painful to stay connected. We feel unsupported and as if we don't belong. We look to other people and the external world to fill the void of the connection, holding and belonging once given to us by the earth. Taking, clutching, conquering, longing for others to receive us fully as the mother once did. Forgetting that she's still here, waiting for us to remember and activate the part of us that longs to receive her embrace. When you consciously connect with the earth, A veil is lifted and she opens up and receives you more fully. You are able to drink from her sweet waters and release what no longer serves you. Stagnant energy falls away and you become connected to all things on the planet. I surrender to the pulse of the mother. May my heart beat in unison with her. I surrender to the pulse of the mother. May my heart beat in unison with her. Oh, that's gorgeous. Thank you, Mother Earth. And in the other deck, the cosmic reading cards, right under the Walk Your Truth was Mother Earth. So this, you know, there's no coincidences here. Mother Earth has a lot of wisdom to share, a lot of healing. A lot of activations when you connect with Earth right now. Okay? That was such a beautiful message of the letting go. Letting go of things that don't serve you and allowing yourself to open up to the abundance of the Earth. Yeah, and at the bottom of it, to go with it, is all paths lead home to your North Star, to your destiny, to home. Inner authority, intuition, turn your gaze within. Go within, connect with Earth, and follow your heart. And then we have the Tattoo Tarot. And look who's at the bottom right now, just looking. Gorgeous Queen of Swords. I'm ready. See, this is what Spirit wants you to be ready. Not necessarily defensive, your heart's open, right? But I'm ready, and I know what I want, and I can, oh, there it is, right behind me. Oh, when I just look over my shoulder, there it is. And this can also say, look over your shoulder one last time, get the clarity that you need, and then face forward and go. So. Get very clear with what you want. It's really important. And I'm a witness of instant manifestations with people, with my clients. Like instant manifestations. Do some work, the path is clear, and then things open up. It is like magic. It is. So know that you have these abilities too. And you have the ability to change your life at any time. All right, what is going on? What does Mother Earth want to tell us that's coming in? Hey. We have the Eight of Coins. So this is some kind of bright idea. You see the light bulb with the wings, like your angels, your loved ones, it's coming in with love. There's some kind of bright idea with something that you're working on, some kind of idea that you have, the work that you're already doing, the career that you're already in, a business opportunity, an idea, something that you're creating. This can be your art. It's putting in the effort on it, and some kind of idea is coming in that's really going to change things for you. Make sure you pay attention to details when you're signing contracts, paying attention to detail to your projects, making something mundane much more beautiful. That's what I'm feeling for someone. But it's putting in the effort, putting in the work. And when you go within and you release the past, this idea is coming. And it's like you're getting to work, and it feels good. Okay, so the tower comes in, shakes them things up, right? And I feel like that's what's been happening. So this is the bright idea. This is that light bulb moment, and you're like, oh my gosh, I didn't realize I was holding on to this. I didn't realize that that person or that belief or that attachment was holding me back. And then when you go within and you clear some things out and you get that clarity, then you're moving forward to new beginnings. The Ace of Cups. A brand new start, love of a lifetime, loving your own life, filling your cup, feeling nourished. Look at this beautiful sun, clarity. Your cup is overflowing with love and ideas and opportunity. And then look at the birds, communication, masculine and feminine, like communicating. I do feel that. Sharing the love. Wow. Whatever this idea is, this communication, it's really changing things. And this is a gift from the universe of a brand new path, a brand new start that you're going to love. Wow, what is this Ace of Cups all about? So something's changing. You're exchanging, even exchange, some kind of information with these two birds, masculine and feminine, or someone in your life, someone is more masculine, more feminine, man or woman, whatever that is, that part is, it could be two men, it could be two women, that's my point. But there's some kind of information exchange, some kind of even exchange. This can be that idea, this advice that's bringing things into balance, and you're being able to give more. Equal give and take in a connection or a business partnership. And this is like paying attention to the details when you're signing contracts, and it's like you're exchanging contracts or something. Well, this is, or passing the baton. Someone's giving you the business, selling you their business. Wow. Something is changing and coming into balance. Yeah. And it's this devil energy. Be careful of the fears that might pop up. The old stories, the codependencies, the addictions. This is what you're letting go of. This is what you're realizing that you're not attached to. The devil is just coming in to say there's something going on with the masculine and feminine. There's something going on in the heart space. There's something going on in your life that's out of balance. Okay? And then what I feel, though, is this energy is coming in to clear this, to bring balance, to bring a new start. Yeah, victory, success, being recognized, growth, a lot of growth. That's what's being balanced out. Let me see what this one is. Yeah, look at that. The scales are coming into balance. Heaven on earth, two coins. The path is opening. The wheel is turning. Luck is on your side, I feel like. So don't let fear and insecurity hold you back. You have everything you need to move forward on this idea, on this project, on this new path. But something is changing in the material world where you're finally being recognized and things are coming into balance. That's what I feel like the Six of Wands energy. You're finally being recognized and then this path opens up. Wow. This is like if someone owes you money, they're giving you the money. Or if it's not that person, the universe is making it right. I feel like someone was taken advantage of money-wise. Things didn't work out. We got the five coins in the last deck, five pentacles. So something not working out. And this is like you're overcoming that. You're finding victory from this no matter what. Nobody and nothing controls you and the universe is making things right somehow. That's beautiful. Amen to that. Yes, please. And look at that. The universe is making it right. Look how much pentacle energy is coming out for you guys. Whoever's listening to this, this is huge. This is like health being restored, manifestation, creation itself, stability, abundance, a business taking off. That bright idea that's coming in with this tower or came in is huge for you. Offer opportunity that is stable. That's what this new path, that's what this new beginning is. Yeah, and it's like that spark. And look, the letter, it's a messenger, the knight, the knave, I mean, coming in, the page of wands. There's some kind of message coming in. I mean, and it's passionate, and it's this like new beginning. Wow. New, fresh energy. And what came out with it? The Empress, yes. Okay, so the Queen of Coins is the Empress manifested in the physical, right? Creation itself, creating your dream life. Taking charge, eagle eye perspective. Turning your gaze to the light, seeing the new path. Someone's coming in and it's like you're seeing it, feminines. You're like, oh, wait, here they come. And it's this page energy. A message from the King of Wands. Remember how we got the King of Wands? Like there's some kind of message coming. It can be a younger person, can be even a child that gives you this idea that but I feel that it's a masculine, it's the king. And it's almost like the child and the Empress are looking this way. What are they looking at? I want to know. What are we looking at here, Spirit? Give us a clue. Oh, yes. And I noticed the sun on the Ace of Cups. Look at it. Oh, we're looking towards happiness, joy, clarity, healing, abundance in all forms. Masculine and feminine coming together for the happy, joyous life. I mean, for the partnership that you've been waiting for. I mean, look at that. The sun is shining in. The most positive card in the deck trumps every other card and comes right on the devil. You're getting clarity on those manipulative relationships, on the in and out people. You're getting clarity on the codependencies, the addictions. You're healing from them. You're breaking the chains. The masculine and feminine are in the devil card are the lovers in the shadows, and they're coming to the light. And it's like everything is coming to the light. And look at the bottom. Come on. Look at the bottom. The Ace of Coins. It's being protected. This is a higher level of commitment. This is marriage. This is moving into your new home. This is the path opening to abundance. This is a brand new start, and it's a beautiful start where there's going to be a lot of growth and a lot of beauty on this path with the rose. Shine your light. Strut your stuff with the peacock feathers and the Six of Wands energy. I mean, wow, you're being noticed. Wow. This masculine, I'm telling you, it's a masculine coming in, and it's like this Empress, this Queen sees the value, like, and sees that, oh, this is my new path. This is my new career path, if it's a job. This is the love of my life, right? That's being activated. This is my divine partner. Like, whoa, things are changing, and it's a really beautiful shift. It's a beautiful, beautiful shift. Brand new beginnings, you guys, through the portal. Brand new beginnings. You got the Ace of Wands in the last deck, right? And you get the Ace of Pentacles and the Ace of Cups. I mean, that's brand new beginnings. And we saw the King of Swords twice, so there's your sword energy with your clarity. All right, our last message here for this amazing reading is work your light, Oracle. Let's see what comes out. I appreciate all of you for being here and supporting my channel. And anyone that orders readings and healings, and you really are helping support my daughter and us moving forward, and I appreciate that. And I love sharing my gifts. I'm part of your soul tribe. You're my soul family. Call in your tribe. You don't have to do it alone. You're not alone. You are never alone. Separation's an illusion. You're calling in your tribe in this portal. Heaven on earth, meeting face to face. Wow. 11-11 union. That's beautiful. And union doesn't always have to be romantic. It can be, but it's your family. It's your tribe. And the Council of Light is working with you. Look at that. Divine orchestration, helpers in the subtle realms. You're being helped. This is all being orchestrated right now. Do you see it? All these activations coming in this portal to you to activate new things within you, to bring in your tribe, blessing you with a best friend, a soulmate, a partner. Answer the call. What is your soul calling you to do? Where is your heart calling you to go? Your North Star, your star family, your tribe is calling you. Answer the call. Somebody literally may be calling you. And we know we don't answer the phones these days. At least I don't, if I don't know the number. But I feel like Spirit's saying, answer the call. Somebody's actually calling you. It's calling someone. Answer the call. And also, answer the call of your heart. And look at this. This is a confirmation. If you've wondered if you're a star seed or you know you're a star seed, things are definitely being activated. What lights you up? For all of you, light workers, mystics, healers, all of the light, what lights you up? This reminds me of what, like Saturn and Jupiter, like first learning the lessons, then the luck and the expansion and the growth and the luck and opportunity comes, and you're following it. So it's like the same energy. It's like you're sitting here and like in contemplating that hibernation, right? Going within. What lights you up? What is your soul calling you to do? It's all being orchestrated. Your family, that you're not alone doing this. So go take a leap of faith. Go for it. This new path is opening for you. Go for it. I want one more message here. There we go. That was easy. Mirror. Look at more questions. Who or what is triggering you? Mirror image. Someone's a mirror image reflecting. Reflect. You need to reflect and move forward. Okay? Wow. You're going to get a lot of clarity here. And look at this. This is a confirmation that you're transforming. Things are transforming in your life. There is the queen with the cat. Things are changing at a cellular level. There's deep, deep healing going on. DNA activations, light body activations. Look at all of them. That's what's happening right now. That's why you have to take a little time out, right? Just take a little time out and reflect, because you've been training for this for lifetimes. You're ready. You're ready for these activations. You can't make this up. Come on, you guys. Don't be afraid of this. Don't be afraid to level up. Look at this. We are activating you right now. I mean, look. Oh my God, it's like coming in from the heavens. Heaven on earth, 1111, activation, healing, enlightenment, the age of the light. You have been training for this for lifetimes. You are ready. Do it. Shine that light. Go for it. Wow. Gorgeous energy. And I'm sending you all so much love.